My name is Juan Botella. I'm a science teacher at Monona Grove High School. I've been teaching here for 11 years. I taught 2 years before in Mexico City. And the courses that I'm teaching currently are AP Physics 1, I'm teaching climate and weather, and I'm teaching astronomy. So most of it is physics and applied physics.
Right now, we already have a working model that will tell us how to find your weight or weight of any object anywhere in the universe. So you want to find a Martian's weight in Mars, we know how to figure that out.
Originally, I wanted to be an oceanographer, a physical oceanographer. So I went to school for a very long time. I started in college doing oceanography. I did graduate school in Mexico. And I came to the United States to do more grad school. I was at the MIT, Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution Joint Program in Oceanography. And I kept working on that. I soon realized that I'm a terrible sailor. So going to sea in ships was always a challenge to me. And then I started working more in the computers and numerical models and things like that to study the ocean. And after a while, I felt that it was very isolating. I couldn't work very much on a topic by myself in the computer, and realized that I needed more human contact. And at that point, my dad shared with me a letter that he had received from the Spanish consulate in Mexico. And this letter was addressed to my grandmother. My grandmother had started teaching in Spain in 1920s. And she taught for a few years, and then a civil war started in Spain in 1939. So they had to flee the country, and they arrived to Mexico as refugees. And she taught in Mexico for more than 50 years. And this letter was from a former student of hers from early 30s, I think. And after 60 years, this person decided to write a letter to my grandmother thanking her for what the impact that she had made on his life. So when my dad shared that letter with me, I was amazed about the impact that teaching can make in a person's life. And I decided that sounds really cool. I've acquired a lot of scientific knowledge that if I can use that to make an impact in people's life, I think that's gonna be awesome. So I decided to go into teaching.
So you have this, that you have the question, and your prediction is when something pushes an object up, it will weigh more. And then, so why do you think push up will make it weigh more?
Because Newton's second law, I think it'll push back.
Third law.
Sorry, it's been a while.
Okay.
It'll push back the same force, so that means it'll be going down with more force, I guess.
All right, that's a great idea. So what I hear you saying is that, like, if this is pushing up on my hand will end up pushing down more. And if I put a scale there, if I push this up, the object will push down on the scale. That's a great idea.
Kids are very good at doing science. And that was like a big aha for me when my own kids were born and they started to make sense of the world around them. And they kept asking questions about why is this like that? Why is that like that? And then connecting them. And it was great just to see them that, wow, they're actually doing science, you know, trying to make sense of the world around them, asking questions and probing and things like that. I think that somehow our brains stopped doing that at one point and developed more connections of, I want to try to get along with the people around me. So a lot of the students that I have are more interested in building interpersonal relationships, which is completely normal. So what I have to do is take them back, I don't know, 10 years, and have them ask the same questions they were asking before, but with a better understanding of what the world is like. So what do I do to prepare for my lessons is, particularly for AP, there's content that we need to cover. And I look at the content and I see what they need to do and be able, what need to know and be able to do. And then I think about an actual situation where that would pop up in their lives, in students' lives. And then instead of telling them, you know, this is the concept I want you to know, I try to present a scenario in which I'm going to pop them in. It's like, you observe this. What do you think about why is this happening? And then I try to devise experiments that would allow them to figure out the answer. Or sometimes think about how can I ask them a question that they create their own experiment. And then I want them to arrive to the answer through my experiment, their experiment. And at the end, we get to the idea that is in the textbook. Something that is that most people don't know about me, I've had the diverse experiences in my life. And something that seems like it's somebody else's life now, but I did it a long time ago, is that when I was a teenager, I started when I was 15 years old, I was a member of a boy band in Mexico, became one of the biggest bands in the world in the 1990s, and they're still touring right now, yeah, which is kind of funny. So yes, I was in a boy band.
You guys did very, very well. You came up with a great idea in different tables, independently on your own. Instead of me coming up here and telling you this is what it is, you guys thought about it, which I'm very, very proud because you guys showed that you.
The award that I won is called the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science Teaching. This is an award given by the President of the United States, and it's administered by the National Science Foundation. So this, I think, has been awarded since 1983 or 1985. And at one point, the President of the United States said or realized, we need to promote people going into science and mathematics because we are lacking people working in these fields. So they said, what we're going to do is we're going to award every year a mathematic teacher and a science teacher from every state, plus Washington, D.C., plus the territories, and plus the military forces. So in total, I think it's like 53 mathematic teachers, 53 science teachers for 1 year. First, I was nominated, and it seemed like a very challenging application. They got an email, such and such, nominate you. And you have 3 months to fill this application. And the application is, it's a great application. I really enjoyed working on it, but I also suffered it because it's a lot of time. It's a lot of reflection on what I do in my teaching. They wanted a 45-minute video unedited of my classroom. And the AV team at Monona Grove helped me film that, which is great. And I got a good video, and then I had to refer to that video in the application. What am I trying to do in the lesson? How I go about in doing it? How do I interact with students? And it's a very lengthy application. It's got a page limit. I think it was 15 pages, which is not very long when you want to write. So at the end, it was about to how can I condense all my ideas in small pieces, referencing to the video. This award validates the work that I do every day. I've done new things, I've learned from other people, and sometimes it's like, well, is what I'm doing the right thing or not? And this really validates that, so I was definitely very excited. I have to recognize that there's many other great teachers in our district that have not applied and have not been recognized like that. And also that I've learned so much by the teachers that I work with every day. This district is amazing because we have a lot of collaboration among teachers. We have common planning time. And throughout the 11 years that I've taught here, I've been sharing ideas with other people. And that has helped me grow. And I would go into the meetings and say, I'm going to do this. And then another teacher would say, have you thought about doing this other way? I'm like, wow, that's great. So this award should reflect the work that we do in our science department and the support that at the high school level and at district level I've had. I've asked the district to allow me to do crazy things like go to Antarctica or bring students to Chile to work in Antarctica. And they have been extremely supportive. And each of those experiences have helped me grow a little bit more, the people I work with a little bit more. So this award should not be seen as my award, but like the district's award that we're doing great things here.